Good morning all. I, Vikram Sharma, Head Department of Mechanical Engineering, Bharatiya Institute of Engineering and Technology, Sikar. Today we are discussing about consider a subject that is measurement and metrology. That topic is Prony Brake Dynamometer. We consider here a small topic of Prony Brake Dynamometer. First of all, we discuss about the what is the dynamometer and what is the torque, how we can measure the torque, and what is the different types of torque measurement machines, and how we can measure the torque, what is the working principle of this Prony Brake Dynamometer, and the construction limitations and advantage disadvantage. Okay, we discuss later on. First of all, we discuss about the what is the torque. Torque is defined as the twisting moment. That is the reason, that is the generating, that is the cause of rotation, that is the cause of rotation, that is known as torque. Okay, how we can find out the torque? The torque is find out by the relation, that is force into distance. Force into distance, the distance is the perpendicular distance from the rotation. Okay, then the unit of a torque, that is Newton into meter, force Newton, and the length is meter. Okay, from this we can find out the torque. Now we discuss about the Prony Brake Dynamometer. First of all, we discuss there are the different types of dynamometer which are used as a mechanical dynamometer. For example, there is the absorption type dynamometer, there is the transmission type dynamometer, and driving shaft dynamometers. Three types of dynamometers are utilized. First of all, we consider the absorption type of dynamometer. Absorption type of dynamometer, there are two types of absorption type dynamometer. First is first type of dynamometer of absorption type dynamometer, that is Prony Brake Dynamometer, and second is the Raw Brake Dynamometer. First of all, we consider the absorption type dynamometer, and the first part of that absorption type dynamometer is Prony Brake Dynamometer. What is the mean of absorption type dynamometer? Absorption type dynamometer means that absorbs the power, that use the principle of brake, that works on the principle of brakes. Okay, and they use the use or absorb the power of that machine and then gives the result. That is absorption type dynamometer. First of all, we discuss about the working principle of Prony Brake Dynamometer. The working principle is very simple, that is the Prony Brake Dynamometer. The power is to be measured. Which power is to be measured? That will be converted into the heat by means of friction and by means of any other means. Okay, that is the working principle of Prony Brake Dynamometer. In other way, we can say that the Prony Brake Dynamometer also works on the principle of brakes, also work on the principle of brake or frictions. Okay, then we discuss about the construction. Then we discuss about the construction of Prony Brake Dynamometer. There are the schematic diagram of a Prony Brake Dynamometer. I explain this dynamometer. There are the two wooden blocks. First of all, there is a lever which is connected by two wooden blocks, and wooden block is attached by a pulley, and that pulley is coupled by the motor or engine shaft, which is to be that is the driving shaft. And here is the helical springs are used with the nut and bolt assemblies, and this is the weight is attached here. One end of this lever is attached to weight, and other end of this lever is connected by the counterweight to balance this weight. If this weight are not balanced, then the system is unbalanced. Okay, to balance this lever, and there is a counterweight is also applied here. Okay, and two stops are provided here, that is denoted by stops. Two stops are provided here to stop this system, stop this lever, control this lever. That is the simple construction of a Prony Brake Dynamometer. Now we discuss about the working of a Prony Brake Dynamometer. The working of a Prony Brake Dynamometer is very simple. This pulley is directly connected to the driving shaft. This pulley is directly connected to the driving shaft, and this is covered by the wooden blocks. Wooden blocks are attached to this lever, through the help of these helical springs and lever is connected to the weight at the other end. When the weights are increased in this end, these brakes are applied. These wooden brakes are applied on this pulley and try to stop this. And this will be unbalanced. And how we can then these tighten them? These bolts are tightened. Helical springs are also used here to provide a grip. Tightening here. Then this is balanced when the again and again we increase the weight. This is balanced, and a time is here to balance this. All the lever is balanced in equilibrium condition. Equilibrium condition when the pulley is stopped and the weight is increased. Then we when in equilibrium condition, we find the torque. Torque is equal to F into R. That is a simple formula as we already discussed in the previous. And the torque is F into R. Here is the force. It is the denoted by force, perpendicular direction. This is the R, and this is the perpendicular distance L. From this we can find the torque, and by the using torque we can find out the power. P is equal to 2 pi nt upon 60. Okay, from this tonic brake dynamometer, both of things we can find out. First is torque and second is power of the that motor or that engine. Okay, that is useful for us to find out the torque and power for the motors and engines. But after this, a limitation is also here. What is the limitation of this tonic brake dynamometer? There is a simple limitation of this tonic brake dynamometer. When the driving torque on this shaft is not uniform. If the driving torque is changed again and again, that will be changed, not constant, then this system will be unbalanced. Or create an oscillation. That is the limitation of this tonic brake dynamometer. Okay, and if we talking about the application of this tonic brake dynamometer, a lot of applications to measure the power and torque of engines and electric motors, etc. To measure the, I think this is very simple system of a tonic brake dynamometer. Later on we discuss about the different things, slow brake dynamometer and transmission type dynamometer and other things of driving shaft dynamometers. Okay, thank you.